So I will tell you a story about the first date I went on after my divorce. When I say divorce, I mean separation. I mean the day that you and your partner shut the door and one of you is in the apartment and the other is on the other side looking for somewhere to live. That day that it's over is not actually divorce, but that's the day it's over, right? I went on a date 2 days after that day. And I felt judged by my married friends, but they didn't understand how horny I was. Because I don't think people understand, when you get divorced, you probably haven't been having sex. It's not like, oh my God, we're fucking all the time in this thing of not liking each other. In this home we've built where we despise each other, we fuck all the time. That's not happening. But it feels weird because someone's in your bed and you should be with them, but you're not. So your body is very confused. It's not the same as single horniness. Single horniness is quaint that you even would complain about being horny when you're single. You're like, oh, I'm kind of horny. Should I call an old friend or maybe get a pizza or just fall asleep? Divorce horniness needs to be taken care of right away because your body starts going into heat like an animal. So the minute that door shuts, you're not in control anymore and your body's just like, ah! Like my body was just like, I was just following it. It was trying to sit on fire hydrants and stuff. I was like, body, stop it. It was like, ah! Like it was going nuts, you know? It's like if you have to get in the house really fast and you have to pee and your body thinks you're home and you're like, don't wet your pants, body. You know, it's that. So I was like, oh my God, I didn't know the horniness of a divorced person. So I went out to see a band play, which is something I never did when I was married. And I went to, you know, talk to the drummer after. I thought he was cute. Now, I wasn't thinking about how old I was as opposed to how old he was. And that's where the story gets sad. As I was 37, he was 20. Yes, I was a cougar for one night. Don't woo. It's not good. It's not a good thing. See, I was a cougar back when Demi Moore and Ashton were still happy. And so I thought it was cool, too. Yeah, older women getting some of them. No. The reason she lost her mind and had to go to rehab for being 50 was because when you're dating a hot young guy, he's hot and young, and he doesn't have to work at it. So he gets to, you know, run around throwing frisbees and whatever young people do all day. And if you're older, you have to sit at home going, don't eat anything! Like, it's a lot of pressure. And that's why they had to send Demi Moore to jail, because she lost it. But I was still buying into the myth that being a cougar was cool at this point. Now, let me tell you something. Now I don't think it's cool. There's no word for a man who's in his 40s and dates someone younger. That's just called a man, right? Sometimes silver fox, that's kind of a cool sounding thing. Cougar doesn't sound that cool. Cougar doesn't sound cool like a lion or a tiger, like rah. A cougar to me sounds like an old woman in the woods in a spotted coat. Oh, I hope someone comes by. It's sad. Don't look up to me with this story, but learn from it. So I talked to this kid. Now, I don't realize he's 20. I don't realize I'm 37. I hadn't been single since I was 27, so I'm still at that age in my mind. So he asks me out for the next night. My body's like, what? I'm like, come on, body, we can make it one more night. It's fine. So I say yes. I get home. My friend says to me, you know that guy was 20, right? I'm like, oh, who cares? I'm a cougar. This is cool. So he texts me the next night. He's supposed to come get me. And he says, I can't come get you. My car broke down. And I'm like, oh my God, I'm such an old loser. Like, he doesn't want to hang out. He's blowing me off. I've never texted with a 20-year-old, except for my nephew. So I don't know what to say to these kids. And so I was like, well, maybe he'll like the same things my nephew does. And I'm like, do you need money for college books? Like, I don't know. He goes, no, I really still want to hang out. I really just can't drive. My car broke down. So I went to get him. Now, it turns out his car didn't really break down. His car ran out of gas because his bank account ran out of money. So no problem. I go get him. But here's the thing. My life is in transition. I'm moving things. I got furniture in the front seat. I can't move it. So I pick him up at the gas station like some bad mother who just lets her kid hang out. I saw the other mothers looking at me like, oh, you let your son just hang out at a gas station all night? I'm like, he's not my son. I'm going to fuck him. You know.